Bhí McCarthy in ann an slithir a bhogo na agus a bhuala, ba cuma an raibh sé an dalamh nó an live nó san air.
Coming to Gerard McCarthy. And Gerard nicely setting a dummy there, shot from McCarthy. And a beautiful point from Gerard McCarthy.
Croker. An Leiter agus an a Kroger ar fad. An stíl imir ha bhíge simplí, dírach agus éfogtach.
Gerald McCarthy, and Gerald sends it over for the lead for Cork again, his second point of the game.
You liked him on your side. He was a fearless player, very dependable, and a great spirit and a great heart. And when you have somebody like that, you won't go far wrong.
In 1966, heis gort de fada, hra omoni hi chorka Cliffy Canish na héirin dan gédúr le Demlíana. Bhí fear óg as cumann var an ifa Gerald McCarthy na chaip tín arhub.
We were like a bunch of young lads up to Dublin to see the zoo or something like that. We sang the whole way on the bus, the whole way out to Croke Park.
He took the captaincy in great style, I mean, for a young player. And that showed his maturity as well, I would say.
Sure, I was only a young lad trying to get my place in the team, so maybe I could have done without it all right, you know. But, you know, I worked through it, and I don't think it affected me that badly, really. And the final whistle blew. It was mayhem broke loose, really.
And the crowd absolutely tumbling into the field. Gerry McCarthy, the captain, coming up to receive the Gerry McCarthy Cup.
It was very emotional, absolutely. I couldn't believe the sea of red faces, the excitement and the cheering.
So Gerry McCarthy holds the Liam McCarthy Cup high.
It was unbelievable, unbelievable.
Ní mhain na sin siad, ach bhí Gerald in na chaptín ar a bhfuil an faoi bhliain agus fich amá.
It was certainly a great, great honour to captain the Under 21 and the senior team.
Cásadar ar Loch Garman sa Tlaith Ceannais agus Craig Nader ar co-scóir Gáv Gáúri Níga Céile an tria úr bhí an bóid Corcaí agus bhí sár tlaithe sa Tlaith Ceannais go mór mhór an tria úr ag Gerald McCarthy.
So the future looked very, very bright and people were saying, God, Cork are going to be there for the next few years.
Ach ní mar a híltar a bítar agus bheith trí blian an solas roi díse Cliffy Ceannais ar íst agus a fhres úr a céana cilch an ilahob.
We were beset by injuries. Justin McCarthy had an accident, broke his leg a week or so before the final. I normally played midfield and I was playing left half back that day. Things went very well for me that day. As a matter of fact, it probably was one of the best displays that I had given in a Cork jersey in an All-Ireland final. We had a good lead in the game, but we never pushed home the advantage. When it's over and you're beaten, you just want to crawl out of Croke Park, really.
Bhí déiseacha brodaí chuir na cheart don bhliain d'Argian, an Tamsha, an Naí Loch Garman.
We were very determined, having lost in 69, that we would win this one.
That's a short pass to Dave Burney.
Fionn Quillan did the ray fain, August Dave Burney on Bleen Shin.
The referee has awarded a free against Gerald McCarthy. Dave Burney put his hand up for the ball, and he's got a knock from putting his hand up, but it's not in the nature of Gerald McCarthy to do a nasty stroke.
Bhí Gerald in an slithar a cumad ag bogus, but bhí sin an bhí sé an train ar an slithar.
Another goal by Eddie O'Brien, who has now
Nebala treated Darn the Yag, Luffy Canish, Nijak Shachtu Do, become the Mahasar Horka.
That put us 8 points in the lead, and that was our last score for the game.
We couldn't sustain it, and when Kilkenny came back at us, which they normally would anyhow, we had no resistance.
Here he comes, he's going for a goal! And he's got it! They're coming, going up the field now. He's on the 50, it's 40, it's 30, it's 21, it's a shot, and it's a goal!
We had the experience of 69 behind us, a lot of us, that shouldn't have happened again, you know?
In 1976, Capel Leach na Lui, Christy Ring, Maronar le Corca.
He really had a great insight into the game, and I can remember the thought that Ringy would focus on things, you know, to get them right.
Chod hi'n lled sgrwdw môr y Ring agos yr Corca, sy'n glwfi canys yn 1976.
We were shocked at the start. There were two goals and 2 points up within 8 minutes.
Pat Moyle.
And still, we are Cork division is top goal. Because, you know, so their division is FFT.
The Rod Fila Egfern Corkig, the Anna Untive Aka, us to Finn, August Lan Chi the Gimmert is a Gimmert.
Slowly but surely we got back into that game, and indeed by halftime we were level, due mainly to a magnificent display by Pat Moylan that day in the middle of the field.
Fi misse ag siúl ar an taobh líne agus fi Christy Ring agus fi mic Jacob ag imar cahuntach cúig sé ar dlúin amháin con suspeoga a thógáil. Da Rick Christy go dí Jimmy Brohan agus da bhéag sé tá Jacob ag dorlí dírseach Cahi to Jimmy Barry Murphy, a corral. I was really sheer in Astro Shin.
Jimmy Barry Murphy, and it's gone over the bar for a point. Another one by Jimmy Barry Murphy, and there goes the final whistle. And the All Ireland champions are Cork.
In 1976, we Loch Garman Loch Bereist, I was five blessed away Cork. Cechai wheelo dish tionchor Mick Jacob.
Fisher Kyondas na lechul hilar is fair satir. Gandout le fada. Agus ana efach tuk a jo. Agus is kosoil gorka ronori korki quid wa hama ex mwin if we shin. Agus hokrik shidar gerald a choris chachan shin mer lechus hilar.
I think Christy Ring played a big part in it because when I was selected to play centre forward, I was a bit surprised really because I had never played there before. I had strict instructions really that day to keep the ball out of Mick Jacobs' hand under the high balls, to keep it out of his hands by just flicking the ball on for 10, 15 yards. I concentrated on doing that, and I found it gave me great confidence when it came off me.
If he love untuk egg Mick Jacobs, he said he masked him or Hori a bar can grind a oil sanir or slither. Ach, near Lig Gerald Doe A.N. of Koheske is a Vishen on the Ganah.
Gerald McCarthy shapes up to take the free on the 50-yard line. And he sent it over the bar, another point, three for Gerald McCarthy.
He wasn't a fella like looking around who's going to do it. You know, I'm going to do it. And I thought that day in particular, that one of those days, that he shone above the rest.
Now there are 2 points between them.
The part Fila Egg Gerald Sutlison Boasian.
Gerald McCarthy to take the free. Over the bar, a point now to increase that lead as Gerald gets his 6th point of the game. And the game is over! And Cork has won their 23rd All-Ireland title.
Bhí siar a bhain ile éirin grú teag Gerald. Ach níor a siar a fós. In 1968, bhí Cork ar hóidin tríú críomhála éirin as a chéile. Thug do ráigh ar chun den chláir, a bhí faoi stiúr Justin McCarthy, ir chumrádaí imirthe Gerald McCarthy.
We had the chance, we felt as a group of players, to really do something that hadn't been done since the 50s by Cork.
Clare feel the same team as they fielded in the first half. They're down by 2 points, but they now play with a strong wind.
Sometimes it's easier to play into a strong wind. You can find more room in the forward line.
For Ray Cummins. Cork still trying to open up the play. As Ray Cummins picks off a glorious point there. And there it is. John Maloney blows the full-time whistle as Cork win their 36th Munster title.
We were put to the pin of our conduct to win that day, and it was a brilliant win when we got there. We knew that we were pretty on course to maybe do three in a row.
Edir agus is spríoc, heas na seán náamh dí Cilchoine agus Gerald in an aigh don gearú uair a glufi ceannais.
Kilkenny were the only team that we hadn't beaten in that 3-0 march. And had Kilkenny beaten us that day, it certainly would have taken some of the shine, I think, off our previous two wins. So that was a huge motivating factor for us.
Echt olvor the chun terbe crevile erne vochen te gaumekent a chun trichi in a chorlekeide tashe sin gohunta gur fader fad.
Heistu IDS in ymmerste shachtu nai chuashele helionorioch dagus eina tibline in oi diagochtu do an xe duerele gur imir korka er a lawmour.
We had a good enough start, but I think the whole thing turned on a high lobbing ball to Christy Heffernan.
I was going to say all along, but not for long. A goal!
It changed that whole game. Changed the whole game.
Dangerous ball. Jerry Fennelly. A goal! A goal! The icing in the Kilkenny cake.
At that time, the setup was really that the Cork County Board picked the selectors, and then the selectors picked the coach, which meant that there was no place on the selection committee for the coach. He had no vote. And I found it very hard to work under that. So when I was asked to stay on in 83, I wouldn't unless I was a selector. I was glad I made a stand in it because it was changed pretty soon after that.
For Shahid first banished the Idr Hunde, Neil and Hunde Duchus, Achlish Nikorsin, Port Laurige.
We smacked on a havoc to Rina Agene, Agus Norahuishach, you know, Ivail or Port Laurige. Vidini Egra Beder Gomer, Jackrip T again, the quiddis Nahim Rorion. Agus, you know, Rina Shagaki, you're a concorus noah, chorus crew a Beder, a hurry vim or ho, or have train all a day.
What I was trying to do was get them together as a team, because they certainly weren't thinking like a team.
Agus a miúl na bliana na eich a hocht, rá Portláirige, cluifi canis na mún a naion chláid. Agus bhí plán eid léheg Gerald agus a chuid ráunari.
We were certainly intent on being up front about everything on the sideline that day. We were there to support our lads. We were giving them every bit of support we could from the sideline. I think Clare were surprised by that, yeah.
Mas a rudig a wil tu eich digi siomra festus agus a rá le lads yna an rud siohi enab agus an rud sinni enab. Well, Orantho Kaffa has been a little fan, Reg, when Ruddy Marshini and a freshen, Agus Nilend out Akur Hugshe, Kennedy of Iantuch.
But here it is!
I think we were very unlucky. Paul Flynn had a great chance from a very long range free that just drifted a whisker outside the post. That would have given us the win.
The atmosphere nivnir sinehemur chacht in an eashin, few solar hussumhlufe.
You see, both sets of selectors were given instructions by the Munster Council at the sideline that we were to sit down in our seats for the start of the game. So we took up our seats in the sideline, but Clare, they were standing up, and the referee left where he was ready to throw in the ball and came over and spoke to them to get them back in, but they weren't going anywhere. I think that set the tone for the mayhem that ensued at the throw-in.
There was drama even before the start here at Semple Stadium because referee Willie Barrett from Tipperary went over to have a word with one of the Clare mentors. And there are strict guidelines today on pitch incursions. It'll be fascinating to see how that works out. James O'Connor, lovely little run. Great block by Brian Green, but it comes to Niall Gilligan. Will he take his point of over a goal?
We knew that we had a game coming up with Galway in the quarterfinal of the All-Ireland. It was something to work towards, and we did that. And I think the display against Galway in that quarterfinal was one of the best displays that the team gave.
Here's Dave Bennett. Skipping by. Bennett. Good shot. That's a great goal. Joe McCarthy has done really well coming back from losing a final, but he did it superbly.
Agus in sin a glufi leith anas na héirin, na cúrsin, Kilchunia, agus Gerald ar Finri, heis glufi canas na mún.
I was confined to the stand, and I think that certainly didn't help the lads.
Paul Flynn, striking the free, battered down.
We had plenty possession, plenty opportunities, but just couldn't find the room to get the vital scores.
Paul Flynn, Flynn shot, oh, it's just got outside, so close. The one that got away.
Ní raibh cúlín amháin atar aige deire. Ní dóilim go bhfaidh Port Láirge seans níos fearr go ceann fad chun craobh a bhaint amach námar a fórsaíodh an bhliain san.
Chá sé trí bliana eile leis na déise, a cháineáin na shréan díhal ní raibh aon ráthair a go d'éibre agus d'éire sé sa ghabhíl agus a hian.
I felt that they needed a new voice anyway, you know, that, you know, they were capable of improving, getting to a higher level, but it was going to take somebody else to get them up there.
Cowrig sé go mór lena daoine a tháinig in aíog mar bhainisteoirí ar Fort Láirge freisin.
Waterford benefited from his presence and from his style and the way he did things. And he gave them respect, which they had to have, which before that wasn't the case.
Dan nu vír a gruim a gavílik sa shacht, agus e vail a chondé dúchas hain.
Certainly, I would not have got back involved with the Cork setup in 2007 if I knew where it was going to lead to and the strife and trouble that it was going to cause. Very quickly, myself and the selectors discovered that there was a lot more involved behind the scenes. It was a period where the GPA were trying to establish themselves, really, to further their aims, to show the association as a whole. What they could do if they didn't get recognised. And I think that was one of the elements behind the scenes. I certainly felt that there was a change of direction maybe needed and that maybe it'll change the style of play just a little bit, that it, you know, it was necessary. If you're kind of a one-trick pony, you are going to be found out, you are going to be stopped eventually. And what I was trying to do was to get players to get a different aspect of their play, to vary their play a bit. I wasn't saying that you shouldn't run with the ball because running with the ball is a powerful part than hurling, but I certainly felt that we shouldn't be running with the ball every time we got it.
Better go left shake here and steal the Aharu, agus near hand shin lesh him Rory. Well, veder thresh ga crave a vochent lesh and steal ella.
Bhí mí áid chuir go ghabhílaigh sa seacht nu na cháil se d'ahamirt go chlufa ceú ceannais na héidan in aghaidh Fort Láirge, agus meas gan gan dá stíl ása deacha banis.
It seemed to be walking a little bit, you know, and facing into 2008, we were happy enough that, you know, things were going in the right direction.
Breaking ball comes out and squeezes it past Kieran Murphy. Here's Ben O'Connor, and that's a lovely point.
Chodr céim níos fuidir ghabhílaigh sa hocht, ach bhí Kilchunia roa agob sa glufi leith anas.
Kilkenny stifled us. They produced the hurling, classy hurling when they needed to. They got the vital scores. They were a better team on the day, there was no doubt about that.
It's Kilkenny who are en route to the All-Ireland final yet again.
It was the end, really, of our reign at that stage. So I thank them for their effort and wish them all the very best in the future.
Ní stearnlíon vliantsin, dír fóchosti bhí vail capachon in vanishtiora Gerald, seasa go chreif shelle.
When they came back to me to ask me would I let my name go forward, I said, was there any objections? They then told me that there was no great objection from the players. There was no objection. They never objected to it at that stage. So when I heard that, I said, well, if that's the case, I'll let my name stand.
Ach, níor an himne dí sástar leis a brósis a chapúchán. Agus júl tá siad imirt fri Gerald mar rannistúr.
Cabas, gomeag sé níos fearda Gerald féin airi as nór a bhí an Aragón tersiúlíder a féin agus na himra hóri. Mas rudig amín na himra hóri id a chuinef gaito airi as. Tá arhu tóke ar mion agus ar agne himra hóri agus Tashi wadni is zekrinish.
Harian dinne elle, agus ne hechti galer rinishe son an club, agus son an junte. Ba kertan a himrari, I wadni is mo massa a vehiko mar guine, ni hawan mar vanishtor.
It was disgraceful that a man of such, you know, ability, character, background, hurling, knowledge, you know, that he was very badly treated.
Final straw really came when I was out of the country and a phone call was made to my home. My kids got it with a death threat for me if I didn't step down as coach. And to be quite honest, I was shocked at that. My father, who was a great hurling man himself, came to me and he said, Gerald, just get out of that job. He said, just get out of it. So he said, you know, it's causing too much hassle for the family and to step down. So I did. There were certain untruths being put out in the public domain that, you know, oh, that I had contrived the situation with a death threat and so that I could step down. But, you know, I was disappointed that I had to step down. Hurling is too precious a game to have things like this happen to people involved in it. I don't think any hurling man should have to put up with things like that.
Honi críoch rána le sérvíse yílis funtioge, sé blian agus gá scór ví tucha ag Gerald McCarthy go chorca.
Look at that old photograph. Is it really you?
A hurler who gave of his best in every game he played. That's what I would like to be remembered as.
Éan uair a bheith a caint le tosaithe Corcaí. No, if you want to say common name for Unbarrancha, Veshidabel Tara, Gur Gerald and Slither is Jack with Tapig, Agus Gohefatuk and Tom Galerco.
I'd respect that man, you know, for what he's done, what he's achieved, the player that he was, and his contribution to the game.
Vishenan, Eavula got Tapig Sinair, the Tapigar and Dolph, Agus Asad Lake Freshen.
You come a long way down this old road.
You live all your life as a kid to dream about all Ireland's, and when it happens, is it worth it? You bet your bottom dollar.